A trip to Van Duzen County Park and Swimmer's Delight. This is a John's Travel Adventures production. We start going south on US Highway 101. After we get past Fortuna, which is south of Eureka and Arcata, we could keep our eyes open for the turnoff to Highway 36, which is what we're going to take. Then we take the Highway 36 turn off, and then we pass over Highway 101, and we're going to be heading east. From this point at the turnoff, it's about 12 miles to Swimmer's Delight. Then we're on a smaller country road, some nice farms and places around, beautiful scenery. And a couple of small towns we go through. If you haven't yet, please hit the subscribe button and make your comments below and hit like. The first town we come across is Hydesville. It's a nice little town, has a good supermarket, gas stations and stuff, not a whole lot of people. But a nice little small town country place with an elementary school.
There's a sign down there.
As it's summer, it's road work season, so there are a couple stops where they're working on the road, and flagmen stop up the traffic. As I said before in another video, up here we have the rainy season and we have the road work season.
The population.
The next town is called Carlotta. It's smaller than Hydesville, so it's really a pretty small town without a whole lot of services, but some pretty little houses. Thank you. Then we start getting into the redwoods. It's shady here, a little cooler, and beautiful forests, and we're right near the Van Duzen River. Pretty soon we come to the sign, Van Duzen County Park, Swimmer's Delight. We park there to take some pictures and we see a sign of a nature trail that's somewhere around there also. We walked around the entrance a little bit just to see what it's like. There is a nice nature trail. And there is some poison oak. It's a three-leaf plant that may irritate your skin. So you need to be careful and keep your eyes open for that. There are a lot of really tall trees there, so you get a great view of old growth redwoods, and eventually we get to the river. There's a place where you're supposed to pay to use the place, and no one's there, but they have envelopes out to put money in and put it in there. I think people overall are pretty honest about that. Now, these are free to anyone to use and replace back there, especially for kids, so no one will drown in the river.
Unrest.
The county park has campsites that are first come, first term usage, and they are pretty private and beautiful settings. And in addition to the day use, which is like $5 for a vehicle, unless you're a senior, then it's $3. So it's not like really expensive or anything. As we get to Swimmer's Delight, they have a lot of picnic tables and little barbecue grills and places for your trash. So people can come enjoy the place and hopefully keep it nice and clean. This is the main swimming area. They have those little markers there to keep people from going below that because they're afraid things could fall off the cliff and bother them. But usually it's deep enough to swim in and kids enjoy playing there. There are a lot of other areas in the river you can walk along. Some are deep here. This is the other side of the closed-off place. And you could swim there also. The water is really clear. It's nice to see. This is the parking area for the day use, along with some picnic tables. And right next to that is one of the campgrounds. It's right by the river. Maximum 8 people per site. It's very nice. Get a view of the river. And there's another campsite just across from the first one I showed you on the other side of the road. And if you walk a ways, you'll see a lot more campsites, very private, and a lot more area of the river that hasn't been shown in this area. Some people brought their own inner tubes to go floating down the river. Thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video.